The president promised a broad international coalition when he announced expanded military action against ISIS. This week, he'll be making his case to the United Nations General Assembly. And as tensions continue to rise in the Middle East, another Hampton Roads ship is heading that way. We were pierside today at Naval Station Norfolk as the USS Misher deployed. It's a scene that's played out before for some, but for many, it's the first time.
It's nerve-wracking. It's hard. Very emotional.
It's very emotional. Very emotional. We're gonna miss him a lot.
They savored their last moments leading up to today.
He just turned a year old Saturday, so he was here to be able to celebrate his first birthday.
We went to the beach and went out to eat and to the movies.
Now that the time has come for the guided missile destroyer to set out for her mission to conduct maritime security operations and ballistic missile defense in the Middle East, their commander understands why families and even his sailors would be concerned.
You can't ignore the news and what's going on over there, so I'm sure the sailors pay attention to that. But you know, that's kind of just what is. We're going in to do what we're tasked to do.
And he says what they're tasked to do, they're ready to handle.
We'll be doing all kinds of different things, international exercises while we're out there, as well as we could be called in to strikes.
They've trained for months.
A lot of work. I'm working up for it, getting ready, getting your brain ready, getting the ship ready, and just training.
But this is what they joined the military to do.
I just want to do something with my life. Kind of better myself and serve my country at the same time.
So while some tears may flow with old glory held high, there's something here that's more overwhelming than nerves.
My pride outweighs that. I'm just really proud of my son.
Farewell to these heroes and sheroes for now, until these families are hopefully gathered here again in 7 months. The Misher returned from her last deployment in December of 2011. She'll now be assigned to the U.S. 5th Fleet Area of Responsibility.